Hello and welcome to an impromptu edition of All About the Disco. I'm your host, as always, Billy. Yeah, I didn't kind of plan to do an episode for this upcoming event, Walk with Discovery Wrestling, just because usually I would record Monday, put out Wednesday, and then show happens at the weekend. But matches are just being announced now. We've got three matches confirmed as we are recording right now. This is like 2 o'clock on the 11th of July. I should have this episode out same day. So yeah, I thought I'd talk about it. Talk about the shows coming up on Sunday. Walk with Discovery, taking place at Portobello Town Hall in Edinburgh. Taking place at doors open 2:30 p.m. First bell 3:15. General tickets are still available if you go to discowrestling.com. So this will be a little bit more I'd say relaxed. It's definitely not going to be relaxed. A little bit more laid back as far as production goes. If you call what I do production, so no background, but we're working on maybe just trying to revamp the production side of things for things like All About the Disco and the WrestleZone podcast as well, just to kind of make it a little bit different, but not having to rely on green screen where my ears disappear constantly during recordings. But we're going to talk about this Sunday's event, Walk with Discovery Wrestling. Like I say, it's been a little bit up in the air for match announcements, and nothing was being announced, barely confirmed until this week. But I think we know why, because owner of Discovery Wrestling, Joe Hendry, has been a little bit sidetracked by becoming an absolute viral superstar. Not only appearing, not only getting into the charts, but also appearing in NXT, part of WWE's crossover with Total Nonstop Action Wrestling, TNA. As well, so there's been a lot going on in the background, which has possibly delayed things happening in the foreground for Discovery Wrestling and Walk with Discovery. But we do know three matches that are taking place, and a little bit of a tease of some other things. So let's just talk about it. Let's get into it. Discovery Wrestling, Walk with Discovery. So first up, we'll talk about things that haven't officially being announced. Let's talk about that kind of thing first. First thing is the graphic you've hopefully just seen is that Tom Campbell will be hosting the event. Tom Campbell, of course, from Cultaholic and from everywhere, from the interweb. He is made best friends and enemies with Jeff Jarrett. He is the man that brought Grado to AEW All In at Wembley. He planted that seed, planted that nucleus. I don't know if that's the word to use, but like I say, we're running off just literally no notes. He sparked the discussion, sparked the thought, sparked the feeling of getting Grado to AEW All In. This man is a talisman when it comes to professional wrestling. He's done ring announcing for TNA as well, part of the UK tour, the England leg of that tour. He just did the ring announcing for Burning Heart. That was the Grizzled Young Vets promotion. Apologies if I've got the name of the promotion wrong there. He's also doing things for Progress. He's done things for North as well. Well publicized things for North as well. He's a fantastic ring announcer, very infectious personality in the world of wrestling and just entertainment in general. The man is so charismatic. It is a wonderful sight that we'll get to see Tom Campbell in Scotland and for Discovery Wrestling as well. So this is gonna be a fun time. Fun time. The other thing that hasn't been announced but seems to be teased is the Big Strong Man put out a video on Instagram saying that there's gonna be a Big Strong challenge at Discovery Wrestling. Now, last time he did that was this past April, and he ended up in a match with Adam Maxted, which he didn't come out victorious on that particular evening. So it hasn't really worked out so far, the Big Strong challenges. He does them elsewhere and usually ends up looking at the lights at the end of the day. But if anyone's going to be stepping up and taking on the Big Strong challenge, we're going to have to soon see. I know there's a guy recently that he's been spotted at the raffles of Discovery Wrestling, who's caught the ire of the Big Strong Man recently over at Attitude Pro Wrestling, and that man being Chip Watson. So we'll see if Chip Watson maybe takes up the challenge of the Big Strong Man. Maybe James Erdos. You don't know. We don't know. Adam Maxted all last time was announced like to appear at the event, but didn't have a match announced for the event itself. I'm all over the place. So that happened. So When you're thinking about that, then I'm sorry for the hands just all over the place when I'm speaking. Moose is taking a seminar tonight in Discovery Wrestling at the Disco Academy. So whether that plays into it, we don't know. I would think if Moose is going to be at the show, it would be announced already for Discovery, because that's a pretty big deal to see Moose back in Scotland, back wrestling in Scotland. So maybe not, but never say never when it comes to Discovery Wrestling. Things happen. Weird things happen at Discovery. My first ever disco show, I saw a man dressed as a fry cook beating up an accountant. You don't know what you're going to see when it comes to Discovery. So there's that. Two things that, like I said, not officially announced. The other thing that we don't know what's happening with is Ryan Richards and the tag team titles. So Skull Brawl are on the poster, so you assume there's going to be a tag team title match at some point on the show. Skull Brawl being, of course, Lost Boy Aspen and Caleb Valhalla. So we'll see if they'll be defending the titles on the night. Just depends on who that will be. But we'll see the return of Kings of the North. Will it be a new team? Will it be a brand new team coming to Discovery Wrestling? Will it be a returning team? We might have to find out on the night, or we'll find out later today. So check out, make sure to follow at Disco Wrestling to for all the announcements that I may have missed or may miss on the run up to Sunday, because like I said, I'm just throwing this out here on Thursday afternoon. I've put Zoom on, and we're going to talk about the card that's been announced. Ryan Richards is the other thing, the other loose thread we've got going on at Discovery Wrestling. At April show, he was part of the group that attacked Joe Hendry. He was very bitter, very disappointed, very peed off that his one-on-one match against Gene Money turned into a triple threat with Leon Slater. And he feels like he's due a one-on-one match for the Y Division Championship, which he's not getting on the show, which we'll talk about in a little bit. So there's a lot of this year a package of loose threads and auxiliary announcements taking place for Discovery Wrestling this Sunday. Like I say, discowrestling.com for tickets. So there's a lot of things that may be announced between now, between me finishing this recording and putting the episode out in a little bit, and then Friday, Saturday into Sunday, we may see more announced. So keep an eye on not only the social media, Discovery Wrestling social, but we'll also try and keep track of the announcements as well at swnscotland.com. And let's look at the three matches that have been announced for this event. So the first match that was officially announced, as in it had a nice little match graphic, we had Leon Slater defending the Y Division Championship against Ravy Davey in a match that, you know what, a little bit surprising, mainly because of how this came about. So Leon Slater, of course, in April, won a number one contendership match, beating Joe Hendry 1-2-3 in the opening bout. He then opted to take his title shot that same night, that same afternoon, in Portobello at the Portobello Town Hall in Edinburgh. He was put into the triple threat. Joe Hendry agreed to it. Triple threat defeated Gene Money and Ryan Richards to lift the Y Division Championship off Gene Money and to become the new champion. An historic night, an incredible night to see Leon Slater in two matches and to also lift the Y Division Championship. Elsewhere on that card, though, Judas Grey defended the Discovery Wrestling Openweight Championship against Ravy Davey, and Ravy Davey lost. Judas Grey retained the Openweight Championship. Now, conspiracy theorists will say that Joe Hendry has purposely placed Ravy Davey into this position, into the heavyweight title match, into a Y Division Championship match, not only because he thinks it's going to sell tickets, it's going to be a match that people will enjoy to watch and witness, but also to stick it to Judas Grey. Because Judas Grey, he's not been quiet about his position in Discovery Wrestling and people getting opportunities and feeling that he's the best in Discovery that Discovery have to offer. So to have the matchmakers, like I said, I'm assuming it's Joe at this moment in time, Joe Hendry, that he's purposely put the man that Judas defeated into this Y Division Championship match to not only kind of show that power that he has in Discovery Wrestling, where he goes, where he's like, "Well, Judas, you've attacked me. You attacked me at this last show. You know what I'm going to do? I'm going to take the man that you defeated, so you think is inferior to you. I'm going to give him a wide division championship opportunity over you. You're not going to get that shot. You're not going to get that title match." That's how I'm thinking about it in my brain here. Leo Slater versus Ravy Davey. I don't know how this is going to go. I think Ravy Davey's going to have to maybe pull out some shenanigans. He does have a high flying background. He can do a bit of risk taking himself. Leon Slater is an absolute different animal, so we'll see how that kind of matches up when you've got Leon Slater, the youngest in charge, against Ravy Davey, who's a Fresh Prince of Jermyn Square. The other interesting thing between this dynamic here in this match is these two may meet again. Well, they will meet again at Community Pro Wrestling, because the Leon Slater is, I don't know if he's actually part of the Cruiserweight title tournament, but he will be part of Community Pro Wrestling in the summer. So I'll be interested to see if there's any fallout from this show into that, if there's any shenanigans at play for this one. But this is the first defense for Leon Slater. First time, first event, he'll be walking in with the Y Division Championship. So hopefully for him, he'll be hoping that it won't be the last time he'll be walking in with the Y Division Championship in Disco. So as a match itself, I think it's going to be a fun little watch. Who's going to win? I don't know. That's for me to speculate, and for people to witness on Sunday on the 14th in Portobello. So yeah, a nice match to kick off with, as it was officially announced on the socials for Discovery Wrestling. Next up. The second match announced on this show, again, they had the nice little graphic on the socials, was the Discovery Wrestling Women's Championship being defended when Emerson Jane defends against Debbie Keitel. And this one probably will steal the show as far as a wrestling match, because Emerson Jane is a fantastic wrestler, fantastic champion, and two-time Discovery Wrestling Women's Champion, and is should be worldwide superstar. She's wrestled all over the world. Debbie Keitel, same. Debbie Keitel is one of those, I want to say underrated, but I don't think she's underrated. I think she's just does exactly what she says she's going to do, and provides fantastic matches, and also picks up wins and titles as well. So this one is probably the hardest one to call out of the matches that have been announced on who would win, because I think Emerson Jane, a fantastic job as a champion, holding that belt aloft and being champion that Discovery Wrestling would want to have. She wrestles worldwide, she wrestles in all manner of matches, and it shows that she can adapt to any kind of wrestling environment that comes across her. Debbie Keitel, she's a phenomenal talent, phenomenal wrestler as well, and we've had her on the podcast, and that, so I might swing some bias a little bit towards Debbie Keitel, even though people know how much of a fan I am of Emerson Jane. I think Debbie's she came out in out of Scotland for a little bit, and now she seems to be getting a little bit of a heel into Scotland a bit more. The current Community Pro Wrestling Women's Champion, as and she's lighting the world on fire with the gals, Anita Vaughan. So Debbie's probably coming in with high on caffeine and just energy coming into this particular match, Emerson Jane. I think this is going to be a particularly difficult defense for Emerson. I mean, she had a out of nowhere conclusion to her match in April against Casey and Myla Grace, a great match that just ended so suddenly, because Emerson is that kind of dangerous individual that she can just do one move and it'll wipe you out. So to see these two clash again, I won't be at the show itself, so I'm hoping this is going to be one that'll be thrown up online in the near future, because it's going to be a very good one to watch. So yeah, Discovery Wrestling Women's Championship, Emerson Jane versus Debbie Keitel. I think this is dark, not even dark horse. I think this is probably a nice solid bet for a match of the night contender. And the final match I can speak about in this very condensed, like haphazard when it comes to production, all about the Disco episode, It's the match that was announced at the end of the April event. It's just went out. Match graphic went out today for it. It's Judas Gray and the Good Times, Rob Stowe and Monstrum, taking on the team of Elijah, formerly known as Elias or Ezekiel, rumor. Joe Hendry and Adam Maxted, a super team, taking on the Young Lions of Discovery Wrestling, which includes the Openweight Champion, Judas Gray. So this all came about at the end of April, the April event at Portobello, when Rob Stowe, Monstrum, Ryan Richards as well, and Judas Gray all planted an attack on Joe Hendry and Leon Slater as well got involved. Adam Maxted came out to make the save. So a lot of I can't think of the word right now. It's not Shanigan. But just a bit of a cluster. I don't know. The big brawl. Oh, big brawl. Big brawl took place, and Joe Hendry was able to announce that at Walk with Discovery Wrestling, which it wasn't announced, that was the name of it at that moment in time, that Elijah, formerly known as Elias, would be coming to Discovery Wrestling on July 14th, and he would be teaming with Joe Hendry and Adam Maxted, take on a team of Judas Gray and the Good Times, Rob Stowe and Monstrum. So this three young lions, three young wrestlers, they're looking to make a name for themselves in Discovery Wrestling. Judas Gray has been doing phenomenal work across the country, and Monstrum's been proving himself to be a dangerous individual, a commodity to have on your side in many places across the country, across the UK in general. And Rob Stowe, he hasn't really come out of Edinburgh an awful lot, but he still puts on a solid performance whenever he's in the ring. So to see these three individuals that have come together, that have been under the guidance of Joe Hendry through the Disco Academy, through Joe Hendry's Edinburgh Academy Wrestling School as well, before it got rebranded. It's one of those teachers versus student kind of matchups where we're going to see Joe Hendry may have taught these three guys a lot of things, but maybe not have taught everything Joe Hendry knows, you know? Bringing in Elijah, Joe Hendry, of course, they've got the musical background. Will we get a little bit of a sing-song for your post show at Discovery Wrestling at Walk with Discovery? That's, you're gonna have to pay your ticket to be in attendance to see that. And then we've got Adam Maxted as well, who's just an absolute incredible wrestler. I said in our recap last time, said in other podcasts I've done on our channel, that I didn't know Adam Maxted's game until I saw him live, and I was like, oh my god, this guy's phenomenal. This guy's really good. So matching up, like, Monstrum will be a heavy force, but Adam Maxted, who's no slouch when it comes to size and power. Same with Elijah, and the same with Joe Hendry. It's a case of will that maybe more chemistry as a team, that they've been around each other a lot longer, like so Judas Gray in the Good Times, will that harbor an advantage when it comes to facing three individuals that haven't teamed together? And if we're looking outside of Discovery Wrestling, Elijah and Joe Hendry will be facing each other that weekend, I think. Yeah, as part of North, Thunderstruck. So they'll be facing each other. So I like to think that possibly that some of that will spill over into this. Will there be a little bit of animosity if one wins over the other at North? Possibly. I mean, if Joe gets an entrance out and Elijah takes some sort of offense to it, then could that carry over onto Sunday? Will we see possibly a rematch down the line? This is all stuff that I'm just thinking off the top of my head, just spitting speculation. This is no way indicative of what may or may not happen on Sunday at Portobello Town Hall. So Judas, again, very vocal. He's probably one of the wrestlers I would say who's going to make it a big in professional wrestling in Scotland and certainly the UK and beyond. He's got that enigmatic quality about him, and to have him be the one that struck down Joe Hendry with the Openweight Championship at the end of the April event, it just shows his intent in Discovery Wrestling. It's not only get championships, get accomplishments, get respect as well for people that may underestimate himself and those that have come through the Disco Academy, like Rob Stowe, like Monstrum, like Ryan Richards as well. So there's a lot coming into this that you might not think about, or maybe I've just made up a load of things that may not be taking place and may not actually be part of the wider narrative of this particular match. But I think this is a match that if you're wanting to get a taste of Discovery Wrestling, this is probably one a match that you got to go see, you know. So front row tickets, I think front row has sold out. I think second row sold out as well. But if you want to find out more, go discowrestling.com. Get general admission tickets. It's an afternoon show. There's a beach right across the road, and you can go to Cervino's as well and get some pizza. But let's do a little wrap up, a conclusion of this preview, and let's see if I hit half an hour or something. I don't know. I'm just been rambling for a little bit talking about this particular event. So yeah, let's in conclusion. There we go. There's my preview of this Sunday's event, July 14th. I think I was in August for a moment. July 14th at Port Bell Town Hall. This Sunday, doors open at 2:30 p.m. First bell 3:15 p.m. It should end round about like 5:30, 6 o'clock, something like that. There'll be plenty of merch, no doubt. There'll be plenty of opportunities to meet the wrestlers as well at this event. I will note that if this turned out to be a total ramble, all I've got in front of me is the match card. I have just went everything else off the top of my head. I have no notes. So I apologize if I've missed out something so inherently important in the story that I've just, yeah, it's just gone from my mind. But what I can confirm is Discovery Wrestling Wide Division Championship will be in the line when Leon Slater defends against Ravi Davey. The Discovery Wrestling Women's Championship will be on the line when Emerson Jayne defends against Debbie Keitel. Judas Gray and the Good Times will team up, take on Elijah, formerly known as Elias in WWE. Joe Hendry and Adam Maxted. There may be a big strong challenge, maybe a tag title match. Ryan Richards possibly in a match as well, because that's a thread that's left over from there. Tom Campbell will be the host for the evening. A lot going on at Port Bell Town Hall. So much so I'm now repeating myself. So I think that's time for me to jump out and just, yeah, keep an eye on socials, keep an eye on swnscotland.com, keep an eye on Discovery Wrestling on your social media channels as well, and like, find out where to if there's going to be any more match announcements, if there's going to be anything else announced for the show on the run up to Sunday. This has been a little bit of a panicked episode, a preview of All About the Disco. So hopefully next time I do it for their next preview, hey, who knows, I might get a recap in for the end of the year. Hopefully I'll be a little bit more like still, and a little bit less, oh my God, I probably should have done a preview. But here we are. Let's get if you got a ticket, if you haven't got a ticket yet and you're in Edinburgh area and you can get to the show on Sunday, go for it. You're gonna get some entertainment. Just go and walk with Discovery. I've been your host, Billy. This has been All About the Disco. I'm gonna go have a lie down. Have a good one. Go enjoy some wrestling.